Okay, we're down at Sodom and Gomorrah still. Right in front of you see some unusual looking spots on this, shall we say, layer of ash. It's not stone, it's ash. Now we'll move in for a close-up of this. And you can see that they're kind of circular shaped. Places. Now what we have found, and we'll move in a little closer here, is that inside each of these is sulfur. That is in most of them. Now the ones that do not have sulfur in them, and this one we just took a bunch of sulfur out and put it in our specimen bag, but the ones that don't have sulfur have a very black center where they have where it's been very hot. So now we'll move in on this one where there is some sulfur still present, and back off just enough so you can see what we're up to here, and we'll go collect that sample in a bag.
Started using this knife, it was very, very sharp. Okay, here this is, and we have collected some more, and it smells and tastes like sulfur.
Now the Bible tells us that it rained fire and brimstone upon the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah. Now what you see in front of you here is the results of large and small, well, varying sized chunks of sulfur, burning sulfur, that have hit. And what we find here is that God rained this burning sulfur down upon this city, and rain is a perfect description of it. It landed just in the pattern that rain would fall, and the stuff, of course, the accumulative heat of all of this upon the city set the entire thing ablaze. The flashpoint of every material there, metal, stone, of course the people, and everything burned, and this sulfur continued to burn, and it vitrified the material around it. After it had burned it all up, sealed itself off from the oxygen, and then of course smothered itself out. And in each of these little crystalline capsules here is a varying size chunk of sulfur, and there are millions of these in these ashes that we have here. Now some of them we have cracked open so you can see the sulfur inside, and others we have left intact, but there are millions of these here. So this shows that God indeed rained fire and brimstone upon these cities. And if you'll look in your dictionary, under brimstone, you'll find that it is sulfur.
wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.